फ्रेंड्स, आज हम कॉम्बिनेशन टॉपिक पे डिस्कस करेंगे। इन द लास्ट टॉपिक, लास्ट क्लास, वी डिस्कस अबाउट परम्यूटेशन। सो अनदर पार्ट इज कॉम्बिनेशन। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज कॉम्बिनेशन। एन अरेंजमेंट, दिस इज ऑल्सो वन टाइप ऑफ अरेंजमेंट वेयर ऑर्डर डज नॉट मैटर। नाउ व्हेन वी से ऑर्डर डज नॉट मैटर, व्हाट डज इट मीन? से इफ इन हाई सेकेंडरी फर्स्ट ईयर एनी स्टूडेंट हैज टेकन द कॉम्बिनेशन फिजिक्स केमिस्ट्री एंड मैथ्स, इफ किसी ने पूछा व्हाट इज योर कॉम्बिनेशन एंड एनी स्टूडेंट टोल्ड दैट माय कॉम्बिनेशन इज फिजिक्स केमिस्ट्री मैथ ऑन द फर्स्ट डे, से ऑन द अनदर डे इफ सेम क्वेश्चन वाज आस्क्ड एंड द रिप्लाई वाज मैथ्स फिजिक्स केमिस्ट्री, सो देर इज नो डिफरेंस, बोथ मीन सेम। सो बाय चेंजिंग द ऑर्डर द वैल्यू इज नॉट चेंजिंग, सो वी विल से दैट इट इज कॉम्बिनेशन। सो आई थिंक कॉम्बिनेशन, व्हाट इज कॉम्बिनेशन इज क्लियर। नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला टू फाइंड कॉम्बिनेशन। सो एनसीआर विल बी इक्वल टू फैक्टोरियल एन बाय फैक्टोरियल आर इंटू एन माइनस आर। सो इफ यू रिमेम्बर एनपीआर, सो हेयर ओनली फैक्टोरियल आर इज एक्स्ट्रा। व्हेन वी राइट एन पी आर, वी राइट फैक्टोरियल एन बाय फैक्टोरियल एन माइनस आर, वी डोंट राइट फैक्टोरियल आर। सो लेट अस सोल्व वन सिंपल सम, से 5c2। व्हेन वी विल सोल्व 5c2, अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस फॉर्मूला वी हैव टू राइट फैक्टोरियल एन। सो हियर आवर एन इज 5, सो वी हैव टू राइट फैक्टोरियल 5। देन आर, व्हाट इज आवर आर हियर? 2, सो वी हैव टू राइट फैक्टोरियल 2। एंड देन एन माइनस आर, दैट मीन्स 5 माइनस 2 फैक्टोरियल, एंड इफ वी सोल्व दिस वन वी विल गेट 10। लेट अस सी वन मोर थ्योरम बेस्ड ऑन दिस, व्हिच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ऑल्सो, दैट एन सी आर प्लस एन सी आर माइनस वन इक्वल टू, वी हैव टू प्रूव एन प्लस वन सी आर। सो हाउ वी कैन डू इट? सो एन सी आर, अकॉर्डिंग टू द फॉर्मूला वी कैन राइट फैक्टोरियल एन बाय फैक्टोरियल आर इंटू एन माइनस आर फैक्टोरियल, एंड इन द सेम वे इफ वी यूज द फॉर्मूला इन केस ऑफ एन सी आर माइनस वन वी विल गेट दिस वन। सो लेट अस ब्रेक दिस नाउ। दिस कैन बी रिटन एज फैक्टोरियल एन। इफ फ्रॉम आर फैक्टोरियल यू विल टेक आर कॉमन, आर आउट, देन वी विल गेट व्हाट? फैक्टोरियल आर माइनस वन। व्हाई? बिकॉज यू सी दैट इफ फैक्टोरियल 6 इज देयर, वी टेक 6, देन व्हाट वी हैव टू डू? वी हैव टू सब्ट्रैक्ट 1 फ्रॉम दिस एंड वी कैन राइट व्हाट? 5। सो सिंस हियर आर इज देयर, इफ आई विल टेक आर आउट आई हैव टू डिक्रीज आर बाय 1, so that means I will get what? R minus 1 factorial. Then here, with that what is there? N minus R factorial. And then, here factorial N by factorial R minus 1. From here, let us take N minus R plus 1 common. Not common, out. Then again in the same manner, we have to decrease here 1. If from N minus R plus 1, n minus r plus 1, I will decrease 1, so I will get what? N minus r. So here I have to write n minus r factorial. So in this what I can take common? N factorial is common, r minus 1 factorial is common, and n minus r factorial is also common. So we will get factorial n by factorial r minus 1, then factorial n minus r common. So here 1 by r is left, and here 1 by n minus r plus 1 is left. So let us solve this. How, what we will get? If I will take here LCM, r into n minus r plus 1 I will get. And in the numerator it will come n minus r plus 1 plus r. So rr will cancel out, n plus 1 will be left. That n plus 1 into factorial n will be our factorial n plus 1. In the same manner, this r with this r minus 1, it will be factorial r, and this one will be factorial n minus r plus 1. So this is the required proof. Practical application, you see this formula or this theorem. Suppose in the question given 5c4 plus 5c3, then according to this formula, what we can write? So here n is what? 5. N is 5 and r is what? 4. So according to the formula, we have to write n plus 1. So my n is here 5. So that I have to write 6, 5 plus 1. And C, R. What is our R here? 4. So this, that means according to this theorem, we can write 6 is 4. So let's see some sums based on the combination. In how many ways can 5 sportsmen be selected from a group of 10? So here total number is 10. Out of 10, we have to take any 5 sportsperson. So that means its simple answer will be 10C5. What will be right here? That out of 10 persons, we have to take any 5 person. That is, here n is 10. Here n is 10 and our r is what? 5. So that's why our answer will be 10C5. On solving 10C5, we will get the required result. But why I have written 10C5? That is very important. Here total players are 10. And in that 10 players, we have to take what? Any 5 players. So that is 5 at a time we have to take. That's why we have written 10C5. Now see another sum. In how many different committees of 6 members can be formed from 7 boys and 5 girls? So in this question, it is given that we have to form a committee of 6 members. But it is not given that all the members must be girl or must be boy or 2 boy, 2 girl. There is no restriction is there. So here 7 boys and 5 girl all together, there are 12 members. And out of the 12 members, we have to take any 6 member. No condition is there. Any 6 member. So that means the total number of ways will be 12C6. Because out of 12, we have to take any 6. That's why it will be 12C6. Because no condition is given. But in sometimes there will be condition. So based on that, we have to do the sum in different ways. That one also we will see. Here there is no condition. So what we did, 7 boys and 5 girls, all together there are 12 members. And out of the 12 members, we have to take any 6. Now that's why we have written 12C6. And on solving this, we will get the required result. Let's see another question where condition will come. In how many ways can a student choose 5 course? That is, the student has to take 5 course out of 9. Total option is 9, but 2 courses are compulsory. So here, out of 9, 2 courses are compulsory. That is, the student has to take that 2 course. So in that 2 course, there is no option. Remaining 3 course, the student will take from remaining 7 subjects or 7 courses. Because total 9 courses are there. Out of that, 2 courses are compulsory. So 7 courses are left. And in these 7 courses, the student has to take remaining 3 courses, that is 7C3. This is conditional based sum. Let us understand once again that in how many ways can a student choose 5 courses? So since here, 5 courses a student has to take out of 9. Total courses are 9. But in the question given that 2 courses are compulsory. So out of 9, 2 courses say math, say science, or say English or MIL is compulsory say. So student has no option. Student has to take what? English and MIL. So that means out of 9, 2 subjects is out. So how many subjects is left? 7. And out of that 7 subjects, now student has to take only 3. Because out of 5, 2 has already compulsory. Student has taken. So remaining 3 courses student can take from 7. So our required result will be 7C3. 2 courses are compulsory. So out of 9, if we will leave 2 courses, then 7 courses are left. And from that 7 courses, the student has to take remaining 3. That's why we have to write 7C3. This is important question, conditional based question. And solving, we will get the required result. Let us take another sum. A bag contains A bag contains 5 different red and 6 different white balls. This is also conditional sum. The bag has 5 different red balls and 6 different white balls. That is, 5 red balls are there and 6 white balls are there. And a person has to select 6 balls out of these 5 and 6. But there is condition given that the student has to take at least 2 balls from each color. That is, minimum 2 red balls or minimum 2 white balls a student has to take. A student can't take, say, a student has to take 4, 6 balls, but a student can't do take 1 red and 5 white. That is not 1 red and 5 white. That is not possible. It is given at least 2 red or at least 2 white has to be taken. So what are the different possibilities here? Let's see. Here 5 red balls is there. So say the student has taken 2 red balls from the 5 red balls. So 2 balls from red taken. So out of 6, 2 is gone. How many more ball has to take? Remaining 4. And that 4 balls student can take from 6 white ball. So C6, C4. That is, if a student take 2 red ball and 5 white, 4 white ball, altogether 6 ball, a student can take in this way, 5C2 into C6C4. Why 5? Because 5 red balls are there. And out of the 5 red balls, the student has to take any 2 red ball. And out of 6 white ball, a student has to take any 4 white ball. And altogether 6 ball. So this is one possibility. Another possibility, a student may take 3 red ball and 3 white ball. So that can be written as 5C3 into 6C3. Out of 5 red ball, 3 red ball a student has taken. And out of 6 red, white ball, a student has taken 3 white ball. So 3 plus 3 there means a student has taken altogether 6 ball. So this is another possibility. Or what may be the case, a student may take 4 red ball and 2 white ball. So out of 5, 4 red ball, that is 5C4. And out of 6, 2 white ball, that is 6C2. So these are the different possibilities or combination. And on adding all this result, we will get the required ways in which a student can take the 6 balls. So this is one conditional base and very important sum. Let's see one more important sum. A polygon has 44 diagonals. And find the number of sides. We have to find that what is the number of sides. So as we know that the number of diagonals can be calculated by using this formula. NC2 minus N. Now you see, suppose I will take a quadrilateral. In quadrilateral, there are 4 sides. In quadrilateral, there are 4 sides. So out of that 4 sides, if I will take 4C2 and I will subtract the number of sides, I will get the number of diagonals. I will get the number of diagonals. So this is the formula we can use to find the number of diagonals. So NC2 minus N is equal to what? 44. Why 44? Because 44 is the number of diagonals here given. And if we will solve this equation, we will get what is the value of N. So NC2, what we can write? Factorial N by factorial 2 into N minus 2 factorial. Minus N equal to 44. So let us take common here. If we will take N and N minus 1 common, then here I will get N minus 2 factorial by 2 into N minus 2 factorial. Minus N is equal to 44. So this will cancel out. Let us take the LCM. N into N is what? N square minus N. 2 into N is 2N. And these 2 I can multiply here. This will be 88. So on solving this equation, N square minus 3N minus 88 equal to 0, we will get what is the required value of N. That is, on multiplication we have to get 88 and on subtraction we have to get 3. So such 2 numbers will be 11 and 8. So that is our required solution. We will get here N square minus 11 minus 8 into N minus 88 equal to 0. That is, on calculating this, we will get N equal to 11 n n equal to minus 8, but minus 8 is not possible, so our required result is 11. So this is another sum, and this is the way we can solve the sum of what? Combination. So I hope these topics are these sums are very clear, and in this way, a student may try to do some other sums. Thank you.